To this day, I always ask Bernard, you know, how did I get to be so lucky?
And my response always is, you were in the right place at the right time.
This was Saturday, December 28, 1991.
That was a good night. I was just getting to the island, and a good buddy of mine, he took me to this club, nightclub called Silly's. Girl, I must. Say that we were looking just a tad bit fly that evening.
They were fly.
I seen someone that I wanted to dance with because I seen her dancing on the dance floor. My problem was is that I could never get to her on time to ask her to dance. And even my last attempt, somebody got there before I did. And she turned them down, so I turned around.
This particular song came on, and I said, ooh, I like this song. And my girlfriend said, let's go ask those two guys over there. I said, okay. So we started making our way towards these two guys.
And out of the blue, somebody that looks just like her and her friend did something like this.
Hey, wanna dance? So we danced.
And, I just focused on her because that was the one that I danced with. So I was looking at Lane and my eyes are like scanners. So I went from the top to the bottom, from the bottom to the top and stopped in the middle. And I was like, damn. She's fine now. Then you will know just what I mean. And at that point, I knew that I had to pursue that woman.
And I'm just standing there fanning myself, you know, hot, hot, hot. And the next thing I know, I see Bernard. And I know he's coming towards my way. And I'm like, oh, shit.
Offered to buy her a drink. You know, just a casual beverage. It was good. I really, really enjoyed that night. I couldn't say I had a better night in a long time, but there were better nights to come.
After almost 4 years of dating, all of a sudden, ba-dam. What happened?
Well, I was right down in this area, in the Pearl Harbor area, getting ready to get on a ship to go to Somalia. The ship delayed our departure by 12 hours, and they told everybody to go home. And then I called her and asked her what she was doing, and they were going to her brother's house for a cookout, something like that. He lived on Hickam at the time, Sonny. And from there, I could go back to the ship. Well, I noticed and I was told that I pretty much ignored the lady all night. And I gotta get squared away and get back to the ship. She took me to the ship and was cussing at me all the way. And it was just one of those things where I'm like, ah, man, I don't need this before I get on a ship. And that was one of those days when the last word that she said to me was, F you, I don't wanna see you again. And that was that. Moving fast forward, over time, I was writing letters to her, pretty much trying to apologize for that night of blunder. And this is the important part about this culminating 3.5, close to 4 years of the relationship that we had, in that I was starting to see some different things. You know, how good of a woman she was and how great of a woman she would be for me. It was at that point, while I was out there, after we landed in Somalia, getting shot at a few times and, you know, being in a few hairy situations there, having an opportunity to come back and make amends. And when I did, she was the only one at the airport for me when I got back. And then there she was. And I knew at that point that was my woman. Oh,
was his first tour of Iraq. Was that your first tour?
That was my first tour.
And there would be times when you can hear over on the intercom while we're talking, you can hear duck and cover, duck and cover. And he would go, Lalaine, I gotta go.
I just couldn't tell her. I didn't want her to be worried. You know, there's places that there are holes and there are bad guys in the wire, as we found out during that time. And there were many times in that year that I could have not been here today.
And then I had the younger ones, Brianna and Butter. And my mom would come over to help out, you know, and I was going to school. I went back to school, right? So it was, I'm working full time, going to school full time, and Bernard wasn't home. That time, that period was the toughest for me. But if it weren't for my mom helping me out, you know, with the kids, it would have been tougher.
It's tough now, right now, just talking about it. That was just the first tour.
Yeah.
Second tour was even worse.
Are you getting emotional?
Mirage rockets. I'm just lucky to be here. I'm lucky to be here. And I'm just glad that my wife held it down while I was gone. I look back and I think about all the years that we've been married, the things much have we been through together. Good times, the sad times. We've always tried to do was have understanding. Over the years, we have developed a trust that is fairly unbreakable. I couldn't see it in any other way. There are a lot of other learning lessons that we've had, but one thing that held all this together is our faith. I have faith in Lalaine and the love that we have for each other, and that helps us to grow every day. That's how you grow together. Faith, understanding, and the one thing that brought you together, that love. And there's other lessons and there's other things that are required to make it as far as we did. So, but that's something that you're gonna have to figure out, just like we did. Understand what's good and good for you and what's not. Because those things will help you to either last 27 years or find another route. Be brave. If it doesn't feel good, don't do it.
You know, all in all, Bernard, at the time, you know, I always thought he was such a good guy, good man. And I remember we were having this conversation just before he went to Somalia. And I said, you know, B, whoever had you then was a fool to let you go.
Before I met Lalaine, and as she alluded to, I dated, and I was going to commit to another, but they just weren't right. They didn't know how to treat a good man like he should. So I give them all the line they need to choke themselves and give me enough information to let them go. When I met Lalaine, I was done. I was tired of the games. I was tired. And she made me feel good about myself inside and my heart. And I always hope I did the same thing for her. And that's where we are. That's what took us to the day when I decided that I want her to be my wife.
Maybe it's about 5 minutes before we get married and starting to get nervous. Not gonna walk out on you, because I wouldn't do that. However, my palms are starting to sweat and I have nowhere to run. Everybody is looking at me, but I just want you to know that I'm gonna be here for you. I love you and I wanna be with you. And we're gonna be here together forever. Just me and you. So, here's to you, baby.
When I found you, I found my fate in your arms. When I found you, I found no cause for alarm. When I found you, I knew this love was a gift from above.
I, Bernard, reaffirm my marriage vows. For better, for worse, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health.
I, Lalaine, reaffirm my marriage vows. For better, for worse, for richer, or for poor, in sickness and in health, until death.
When I found you, I found a scholar with style. When I found you, found one more reason to smile. When I found